And someone who covered her for a number of years on many levels, our good friend Ben Yount from Illinois Watchdog, Illinois Watchdog Radio 2, IllinoisWatchdog.com is the website. Ben's got a couple of minutes for us here to reflect on the life of Judy Barr Topinka. Ben, as I said, you covered her for a number of years. What are some of your most vibrant memories of Judy Barr Topinka?
We may say that they don't make them like her anymore. It has never been more true. This is a woman who, she told you like it was, no matter what was going on. If something didn't make sense, she didn't try and flower up the sentence. She didn't use a bunch of $10 words when she could use 50-cent words. Judy Barr Topinka I hope this is the case. But from what I've seen, she's one of the last candidates who understood that you talk to people like people. You don't talk at them. You don't talk above them. She made government real for people who just want to, you know, they want to know why their schools aren't better. They want to know why their doctor doesn't take certain patients anymore. And Judy Barr Topinka explained that. She was great in all of her campaigns. I'll never forget the campaign between Topinka and Ron Blagojevich. She always just sort of had this, I don't think she ever said it, but she always had the general appearance of, I can't believe I'm losing to this guy. but she really, her legacy will be that she took a nothing office, the comptroller's office, which if you think back to early Dan Hines, Lolita Diedrichsen, I mean, think about mm-hmm. who has been comptroller in this state. It was the ultimate B team office. You got elected comptroller and you waited your time to take a shot at Secretary of State, Attorney General, Governor. She turned that into an office that was important. It became the fiscal watchdog of the state. People in Illinois know how bad Illinois is
right
because of Judy Barr Topinka.
Ben Yount with us, IllinoisWatchdog.com. It's Ronnie and Scott on WROK. You look back at her career, that is quite the political career. State House, State Senate, Treasurer, Comptroller, Governor's race, GOP nomination for Governor back in 2006. That is a legacy left in Illinois politics.
Yeah, she won statewide. She served her district. She was an outspoken woman at the State House when that wasn't necessarily commonplace. I mean, and she has always been Judy Barr Topinka, or as people of a certain age will always remember, she is and always will be Judy Bada Binka. that was one of the best commercials that there were. But I mean, you know, she could have walked away after losing to Ron Blagojevich, and mm-hmm. she could have said, "Fine, you've decided, you're stuck with him. Good luck, Illinois. Pack up and move to Florida and be bitter." But she didn't. She came back and she served the people of the state. And I think it is fitting that she was looking at another 4 years because, you know, Judy would not have wanted to go and sit someplace and not be part of the process. She had that kind of energy. It really is. It is one of these days where, you know, you cover these people, you kind of get to know them and you see their role on the grand stage. And then when something like this happens, you realize, man, Illinois just lost somebody who really, she understood the idea of being a public servant. She mm-hmm. wasn't grandstanding. You know, Ron Blagojevich wanted to be governor because he wanted everybody to know his name. Judy Barr Topinka ran for comptroller because she wanted to fix the state of Illinois, and it's, I don't know, if you did not get to know her, if you are just becoming politically aware, all of these young people who voted for the first time in this, you missed out on something, and go find your county chairman and ask them about Judy, because she's I fear that we won't see anybody like her again, because
right.
The candidates now are so vanilla.
Right. What made her Judy Bar Topinka would make a candidate nearly toxic these days? The straight talk, for lack of a better term. She wasn't a conservative, you know, for the Republican Party, but did reflect voters, obviously, having won so many times statewide. And I must ask, was she the best accordion player politician you covered?
She, the band between the State House band, she on accordion, Sheila Simon on banjo, may not sound very good, but it was it certainly would have been a musical State House. I mean, this is a woman who brought her dogs to work. This is a woman who proudly proclaimed that she shopped at thrift stores. Rob Blagojevich, we find out, was having handmade tailored suits. Judy Barr is going down to the thrift store to pick up some stuff. She gave out cheesecake. One of the most popular days in the spring session, the entire State House, Democrat, Republican, insider, visitor, you know, elected officials, just random reporters who wanted some cheesecake, we would all file through her office. She would sit on the counter or sit on the desk, and she'd be wearing, were they like barefoot slippers or Flintstone feet slippers, and she would, how you doing? And she gave out Eli's cheesecake all day long. It was one of those State House traditions that she carried over from the old way that business was done to the modern State House. And it just, again, the only thought that keeps running through my head is we the taxpayers have lost somebody who's on our side, and God, I don't know if they're ever going to make them like her again.
Ben Yount with us, IllinoisWatchdog.com. It's Riley and Scott on WROK talking about the death of Judy Bar Topinka early this morning at the age of 70. We kicked this around this morning, and it just simply is a question that has to be asked in a situation like this. And we didn't know. What is the process now to replace her in the comptroller's office? She had just won, as you mentioned, another four-year term. Do we know what happens next?
I think, and I'm not 100% sure, I got to check on this. This is part of what I will do before I jump on my radio show here in a little bit. I am 75% leaning towards, I think the governor gets to make an appointment to fill the seat until there is a special election. I think that we are going to have to, because she hasn't
right.
sworn in.
Right.
So there will have to be an election for that next term. The interesting thing is you have a Democratic governor on his way out the door,
mm-hmm.
and so you may have a situation, because obviously we're not going to get an election in the next 30 days. You may have a situation of somebody carrying over and serving under a Democratic appointee under a Republican governor, or because we're so close, I don't know. I mean, is there a Pat Quinn appointee until Bruce Rauner can appoint? That's what I have to figure out. But I do believe sooner rather than later, because she was not sworn into that term, someone is going to have to be elected to that term. And it's sad to have to talk about the succession and the politics of this on a day like that. But as I said earlier, and the importance of the Illinois Comptroller is, they are the keeper of the state's checkbook.
Mm-hmm.
She was the one standing at the top of the hill shouting, "We are broke. You cannot spend like this."
Well,
and whoever takes over her, whoever fills her role, needs to continue that kind of advocacy, that kind of warning for taxpayers.
Ben, in a way, too, she was the one deciding who got paid and who didn't get paid, right? We have, at last count, $6.3 billion or so, the backlog of bills. So part of her job, which I'm sure is not in the job description necessarily, is determining who gets a check and who waits another month to get their money.
Yeah, she would tell the story constantly of getting calls to her office from doctors, dentists, nursing homes, pharmacists, people involved in the Medicaid system, small businesses that sold food to prison, bullets to prison, that sold paint to IDOT. And she said that one of the most difficult parts of her job was saying, okay, well, this person called me. He said if he doesn't get a check by the end of the month, he's going to go out of business. Let's see if we can get him, maybe not everything, but let's get him something. And you know, she had a very difficult task mm-hmm. in managing a state that spends, you know, in excess of billions of dollars more than it really has. So, yeah, I mean, she stood up to the Democrats, and I have a sense she would have stood up to Bruce Rauner, because, you know, the politics did not matter as much as the public service. But yeah, she took the comptroller, which was essentially a processing stop. You know, the bills come in, they sit in the agency,
sure.
They go to the comptroller, they stamp it, the check goes out. She really turned that office into more than just simply a repository for checks.
All right, Ben Younts from Illinois Watchdog, illinoiswatchdog.com. We'll let you run, get a big radio show this morning, but really appreciate the time and the reflections on Judy Bart Topinka.
Yeah, thanks so much. And if you didn't know her, you missed out. It's, you know, I'm sad for her. I'm sad for her family, but I'm really sad for the state of Illinois. I cannot get past the sense that we as a state, we as people, lost something last night.